Hey everyone, welcome to part 3 of the video series where we examine the life cycle of writing and deploying a Chialisp smart coin. This is a continuation of the piggy bank coin that we started writing in the last video, so if you haven't seen that one, go ahead and go watch that one before you come back here. Last we left off, we had created most of our piggy bank's logic, but we did not implement the two functions that will generate the appropriate list of conditions depending on the type of spend we are executing. Let's go ahead and define those now. So I'm actually going to go ahead and do recreate self here first. And this is the common scenario. This is I put some money in the piggy bank. That's it. We haven't reached our savings goal yet. We just put some money in. The piggy bank recreates itself with a new amount. And we go on with our lives. So let's go ahead and do this one first. We're going to go ahead and say recreate self. And we're just going to pass it all of the stuff that our spender has given to us. So we're going to pass it my amount, new amount, and my puzzle hash. Cool, let's go ahead and define this function. So this is gonna be an inline function. I'm not gonna go into why this is at the moment, but if you are curious, you're gonna wanna go ahead and read the optimization section on chialisp.com. Basically, it's a good rule of thumb to use inline functions unless you're doing something like recursion or recalculating values that are getting passed in. If you read the page, it'll all make a lot more sense. So we're going to call this function what we've already been calling everything, recreate itself. And we're going to go ahead and pass it the same arguments, my amount, new amount, my slash. Cool. All right. So the meat of this function, what is this function supposed to be doing? When we run a Chialisp program, we expect a list of conditions to come. So all this is going to do is return a list of conditions. Let's go ahead and start with a list. And inside that list, we're going to have more lists. Usually we do this in Chialisp when we're trying to return our conditions is we return a list of lists. Now we're going to be making conditions here and conditions each have their own opcode. And usually when we're referring to the condition codes, they have cool names like create coin or assert my puzzle hash, stuff like that. Those are usually defined in some other library file, so we need to go ahead and get that library file to make life a little bit easier for us. We're going to use the dev tools that we haven't used yet for the first time now. I already have the help message up here, and we're going to go ahead and use this Chialisp family of commands. So let's go ahead and see what is in there. Now, I'm going to touch on all of these commands throughout the tutorial. But for right now, the one that we're going to need is retrieve. And what retrieve is going to do is it's going to go ahead and grab us a library file that already exists in our virtual environment, and it's going to bring it into our project for us. I happen to know that the include file that we need, let's see, cdv chialisp retrieve is called condition codes. If we go ahead and hit enter, you'll see it made an include folder in our project. And inside we've got condition codes.clib, and this has got all of our opcodes just handily aliased so that we can use the names rather than the numbers. Cool. Let's go ahead and head back to our Chialisp project. We're going to need to make sure that our Chialisp project knows about this. So we're going to use the include keyword condition codes.clib. When our dev tool actually builds this, it's going to know to look in the include folder. But importantly, things like run and brun don't know about this. So if you're using run and brun, make sure to specify what paths to search in for the things that you're trying to include. Okay, let's go ahead and start making conditions. So what are we going to do as our first condition? Well, we do know that the one thing that we're doing here is we're recreating ourselves. So let's just do that right now. We're going to do create coin, my puzzle hash, and new amount. Cool. And if we're not being secure, this is all we got to do. We just got to create ourselves with the new amount. Easy peasy. We'll talk about security a little bit later, but let's go ahead and define the other function right now. It's going to be just a little tiny bit more complex. First, we're going to do all the steps we did for the last one, turn it into a function. This one actually needs the cash out puzzle hash as well, because this is the scenario where we have reached our savings goal. And so now not only do we have to recreate a new piggy bank, but we need to pay everything that we've saved so far to our cash out puzzle hash. So I'm going to go ahead and pass it that right now, cash out puzzle hash, and also the same arguments that the last one had. We're going to pass it my amount, new amount, and my puzzle hash. Cool, let's go ahead and define it. We're gonna make it an inline function again. And we're gonna give it all of the same arguments. Let me just go ahead and copy paste those. All right. And again, this function is just returning a list of conditions. So we're gonna start with list, and inside that list, we're gonna have more lists. So what do we gotta do in this scenario? Well, like I said, what we're doing first is we're cashing out to our cash out puzzle hash. So let's go ahead and create a coin. Create coin, cash out puzzle hash, new amount. This will create a coin to the new puzzle hash with the new amount. This is not just the target amount. We could make it that if we wanted to, but then we'd have to do some calculations subtracting the new amount and the target amount to figure out how much change is left over, unless we just want to burn it as a fee. It's much more nice to just send the whole new amount to the cash out puzzle hash and recreate our new piggy bank with an amount of zero. Let's go ahead and do that now. So we've already created a coin to our cash out puzzle hash address. And now we're going to go ahead and create another coin to my puzzle hash, and zero is the amount. So this is creating a blank new piggy bank. It's going to have the same exact target amount because we gave it the same exact puzzle hash. And so this is going to go on forever. You can never destroy this piggy bank. This piggy bank is unbreakable. But yeah, that's pretty much it as far as functionality goes. It's very worth saying, don't try to go to the network automatically and be like, I have this piggy bank coin and deploy it, because this is a very, very insecure smart coin at the moment. In the next video, we're going to go ahead and start talking about security, why this is insecure, and what we can do about it. But until then, if you have any questions, if this has been too much to process, go ahead and head over to the Chialisp channel on Keybase and ask us questions. We're generally available there, so we're happy to help you out. But until then, I will see you in the next.